Ecco, come vi avevo promesso, stiamo andando in Inghilterra, stiamo andando sia a Nottingham che a Sheffield. Sono due città molto importanti, vedrete delle cose molto interessanti. A Nottingham ci sarà la targa ad Herbert Kilpin, l'uomo che fece il calcio in Italia, che aiutò Edoardo Bosio, e a Sheffield ci saranno i 160 anni dello Sheffield, quindi il suo compleanno ufficiale. Grazie a tutti voi. Al 191 dove abitava proprio Herbert Kilpin. Suo papà faceva il macellaio e ci sono tante cose che vanno sapute sulla sua vita. E proprio qui hanno messo questa targa, come potete vedere. Herbert Kilpin, the father of Italian football and the founder of Milan Football and Cricket Club, AC Milan, was born here the 24th January 1870. Interessante vedere che hanno messo anche una pubblicità, come potete vedere, alla fermata del Pullman. Ecco, siamo qui in compagnia di Jared Wilson.
Ciao!
Anche Jared Wilson ha fatto un film su Kilpin, adesso faremo alcune domande a lui. So, which is your emotion to have done another movie about Kilpin?
Well, basically, I mean, this means a lot to us here in Nottingham. For me personally, like, A, I'm a big football fan, not to count the oldest league club in the world, and B, I used to walk past this building twice a day, I still do actually, on my way into work. And I used to work in the building. Our old office that we've only just recently moved out of was next door to the Adams building where Herbert Kilpin was a lace merchant. So when we found out through Robert that this man had founded AC Milan, we couldn't believe it really. Like AC Milan, this massive club, and in England we all grew up, you know, thinking of, you know, that era with Van Basten and Gullit and Rijkaard, and generations after me with Shevchenko and Kaká and others. So it's amazing, an amazing story, and we just wanted to tell it, you know, and show some of the ripples that happened.
Great, thank you.
Cool, thank you, Victor.
Oh, if it's only not be able to sing the songs. Give us an AC Milan song.
Forza lotta, vincerai, non ti lasceremo mai. Ale, 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 Milano, ale. Forza lotta, vincerai, non ti lasceremo mai.
Round of applause. I thought it was brilliant, but brilliant by the Birmingham accent, you know what I mean? I just didn't think it was there, you know. Right, where's everybody from? Hands up if you're from Dudley. Hands up if you're from London. Yes, one, yeah, okay. Hands up if you're from Italy.
Italy.
Okay.
Torino, Turin.
Turin, oh, okay. Then that's because he went to Turin first, yeah?
Yeah,
yeah,
okay.
Years. Yeah, okay, excellent. And then, hands up if you're a Pies fan.
Hey!
Yeah, I thought they were really Hands up if you're Forest. Ooh, not here today. That's a Forest. Why were they so shy? Perhaps they're not top of the league, what like Pies are they?
We're second.
Oh, I thought you were top again. What happened?
Knocked us off.
We're top.
Today.
Oh, okay, right, okay. Yeah. Are we at 2 o'clock yet? Because we don't want to start before anyone... So hands up if you've seen AC Milan play.
Yeah.
Okay. Hands up if you're a member of the Kilpin family. So we've got four, yeah?
How many?
Three. Three, okay, you were just...
Ellen.
You were four.
Ellen.
I'm confused. How many have we got related to Kilpin?
One, two, three.
This lady here as well.
Four,
No,
she's
a Spurs fan. Oh, right, okay. She's a Spurs fan. She's got to kind of like Spurs as well. Okay. Yeah, and we're doing on time. We're there, yeah?
I don't know. Has anybody got the accurate time? Because I'm broadcasting live.
Well, I've got accurate
so
time.
I can't,
2 minutes to go still,
phone.
Yeah. So what's the latest Milan result? They're playing today, is that right?
They're playing Genoa today.
Genoa, right, okay.
So for those that know, they're going to be showing that in the Herbert Kilpin pub as well, straight after this.
Yeah. We have for us the European Championships now. I think it's one thing is important for us, I think, to grasp is why football is important, but football is important in a context. Nottingham has had a very significant role in the world of football, but how it came to have a significant role is important for us to know so that we understand more about our city and so that we value our city more and do more with and for our city. I remember Mark Pugats. You everyone know Mark Pugats, who does the Sky stuff now, I think, doesn't he? But what he said on his final day on Radio 5 Sports Live was, football is the most important thing in the world of all the things that are unimportant. Because the things that really matter, we all know, are other things. But competitive sports is a great entertainment and such a big thing. The first professional game that we had in Nottingham, by the way, I'm not a trained historian, so I'm afraid this is me preferring to live by the myths and the legends. If you want to know the real facts, you probably need to double check with yourself. But the first professional game in Nottingham took place in the area that I represent. I represent the city centre and the Meadows. And that's the area to the south of Nottingham city centre, which only got developed when canals got developed, when railways got developed, because then the civil engineering was available. And because it was available then, a lot of the grounds that are important to the history of Nottingham developed and started there. But there was a pub or a hotel called the Cremorne, and it had some big grounds. And that's where the first professional football game took place between a Nottingham team and a Sheffield team. The rules then were that you won the game by either scoring more goals, or if there was a draw in goals, who scored the most rouges. Hands up who knows what a rouge is. Yeah? Sorry, did someone know? No, because this is the thing about this, right? This explains why you needed someone to start football officially and properly, so we all worked to one set of rules. The rouge was a bizarre thing. Imagine a corner. Imagine you fired a shot at the goal and it's come off a defender. If there was between two flags either side of the goal, if you then ran and touched that ball to the ground like a rugby try, you got a rouge, right? I think there's a very clear reason why we don't bother with the rule of rouges in football today, but it clearly didn't survive very long then. It needed one set of rules. Why? Because it was becoming a national game. Why was it even possible as a national game? Because of the railways. Right, so the first thing to understand is how football comes about in its current form because of industrialisation and because of the railways. Of course, the Meadows is incredibly important because of Notts County, and I look to my friends here from the Notts County fans, where the oldest football league club in the world started and still plays today in the Meadows. And they started at Queen's Walk. They then started at a place called the Castle Cricket Ground. Anybody ever heard of the Castle Cricket Ground? Yeah? Hands up if you know that one then. Two. Are you a historian on this then? Okay, right. The thing about this is that even people who live in the houses that's been built on that cricket ground don't know it exists.
The Trent
right?
Bridge.
Yes. No, yeah. it was a street called Glacton Road, and there's some terraces that go all the way from A to F. Attercliffe, Barnsley, Connersworth, Doncaster, Ferriby. And the football ground lay between Barnsley and Eckington Terrace. And my co-councillor lives on Barnsley Terrace. And the last football ground, the first version of Accrington, because we all know Accrington Stanley. So Accrington Stanley is the third club from Accrington. The first club was called Accrington, and its last ever football league game was in a playoff. They had a playoff between the top league, at the bottom of the top league, and the top of the second league, who that year was Sheffield United. And I think some 10,000 people came to watch that game. And the goal that probably put Accrington out of football league business, because when they lost they decided not to play again in the Football League. It was probably stored in the living room of my co-counsellor, who is on Barnsley Terrace. So Accrington, a little bit of history there, and then of course Meadow Lane, so important. It's an icon really in the history of British football. Forest of course played there. Forest played also at Castle Ground for a couple of years, but also they played famously at the Town Ground. And if you know your history about Nottingham at all, you know that the Town Ground got to 10,000 capacity. It was a proper, tidy, neat stadium. Got to 10,000, held FA Cup semi-finals, and Forest decided they wanted to have a bigger stadium. So they built this stadium just at the time that Nottingham was changed from being a town to a city. It had been called Town Ground because it was beyond the Town Arms, the name of the pub just on the start of the Trent Bridge. It became the City Ground because they wanted to commemorate the fact that Nottingham was becoming a city. It was that important. And of course that was then built in Nottingham. And it's only in 1948 when they changed the boundaries of the city that we lost the City Ground to Nottingham, so that we could build the housing estate in Clifton. Right? But Forest, hugely important to us. We've got the Brian Clough statue. We've got the fact that they won the European Cup twice. So, football started in England. Started in England because the industrialisation started here. Why did we pioneer the industrialisation? Because we were the one country whereby we had religious tolerance. So the Quakers came. The Quakers got established here. They could grow here where they couldn't grow anywhere else. They became, you know, many in numbers, but they didn't have any wealth. And that was because all the land and all the business that's associated with land and farming had all been captured. So they looked for a new angle in life, and they looked to pioneer on industry, industrialization. So the Quakers pioneered on industry, and we became the most powerful country in the world because of what they achieved. And the Quakers started in Nottingham. They started at St. Mary's Church because the guy called Fox stands up at the front pew and challenges the vicar and says, what you're saying is not right. So that story comes around again. But the key thing from all of that is this. Football happened because of industrialization. Industrialization happened because of tolerance. And that's the thing we've always got to remember in football. We've had too much in the past of intolerance of football. Heck, I was a football supporter in the 70s. I saw a lot of it myself. So tolerance is important, and then developing industry and developing our wealth is important.
Thank you very much for coming, everyone. We're gathered here today at 191 Mansfield to celebrate the life of a man who was born and raised here, went to school nearby and worked in the lace market before departing for a faraway land where he left his mark.
Okay.
You want to say anything else, or do you just want to unveil it, or?
Well, how far did you get?
Not very far.
Okay.
You read it.
All right. So, we're celebrating today Herbert Kilpin, the founder of Milan Football and Cricket Club, known to us all now as AC Milan, one of the most successful club sides in world football. Herbert was a good footballer, playing for the nearby St. Andrews, and that's the church up there, and then for Notts Olympic at the Forest, up the road and over the hill. He was not an exceptional player. What was exceptional about him was his drive and determination to be as good as he could be. And I'll say this in quotes, teach the Italians how to play the game properly. I think they might have taught us a few things since. When he died in 1916, the headline of an Italian newspaper article said that he was the pioneer of Italian football. His efforts, along with those who played both by his side and against him, are there for all to see. Four World Cups in comparison with his own country's solitary victory now over 50 years ago. Herbert was indeed a hero of the game. He led his club to its first three Italian championship titles, and he was responsible for the red and black stripes the team has won throughout its 117-year history. On the evening in December 1899, when the club was founded, he said, "Our colours will be red because we will be the devils, and black, signifying the terror we will strike in the hearts of our opponents." We can all see that Herbert's house here is now painted in the colours he gave to his football club. The image of Kilpin you see through this window. This remarkable transformation of this building from an abandoned, dilapidated shell in the last year, the fact that we are all here today to celebrate, is down to the efforts of the property's new owner, Majid. Have I said that right, by the way?
Yeah.
To whom everyone connected with the Kilpin project owes a debt of gratitude. On a street that is like thousands of others up and down this country, we now have a remarkable building to go with the Kilpin bus stop and bus, courtesy of Nottingham City Transport, telling a remarkable story to everyone who passes by. Hopefully for years to come, local children will stop and think that if someone like Herbert could start from such ordinary beginnings and do something so extraordinary, then why can't they too, in whatever areas of life they choose for themselves? And so it is, with great pride and pleasure, especially for someone like me who supports football, don't need to mention the club, except we are unbeaten and we're not Manchester City, who loves football and whose ward includes Meadow Lane, the home of the oldest professional football in the club, that I unveil this plaque to mark the birthplace of Herbert Kilpin, the founder of AC Milan and the father of Italian football. Okay, I'm told Kilpin wouldn't have wanted to make a fuss about him and that he was happy to stay out of the limelight. But it's time for the Lord of Milan to return home as football has come home. This is his city, and many of his people pay for his plaque through a crowdfunding campaign organised by Left Lion because they are proud of his achievements. So welcome back, Herbert. Forza Herbert Kilpin, forza Milan. And now, lads, give us a song.
Lotta vincerai, non si lasceremo mai. Ale, 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 ale. Forza lotta vincerai, non si lasceremo mai.
Well done. You can still hear the Birmingham accent, can you? Right, what are we doing now? Are we going in or what?
We're going on the bus to the
pub. Going on the bus. Oh, okay, right.
I just need to talk.
So, thanks very much. Particular thanks to the Dudley boys.
Here's Victor and his mum. You've already met, but do you want to say anything? How was that for you, Victor?
It's a great day, and I hope it can be remembered for all the people.
Thank you.
Do you know something about Herbert Kilpin and his mother, Thomas Adams? They say no.
No. He's not very well known until recently.
No, they have to know.
You've been in here before?
No.
No? Ah. Yeah. The Herbert Kilpin, the AC Milan project.
Then you open the door.
Okay.
Wood, cartolese.
I'm doing a complete reportage of today, complete reportage.
Are you Victor Egan?
He's there.
Oh, I've heard about you. They look great. I've seen some of them. Pardon? Yeah, I'm the director of Morricone.
No doubt we've tried before. We've brought this up.